Hello students, before we start our chapter, I would like to request you all to watch our introductory two videos given by me so that you will be clear about the three-step strategy to do dhamaka in physics exams. We have given the videos in the description box, or you can just click on our videos displayed at the end of this video for either introductory two videos or the next videos. Okay then, let's enjoy physics by Mr. Patel, who has a long, profound experience of 29 years of teaching physics in Sainik School, Balaji.
Chapter 9, Ray Optics and Optical Instruments. The optics, what is optics? The study of the nature, production and propagation. What is the nature of the light? There are many theories. And how the light is produced? We know that is due to the light emitted from the molecules or atoms, and propagation, that it propagates in the form of waves or particle also, some scientists they said. Now it is divided into two parts, ray or geometrical optics. Let us see about the ray or geometrical optics. What is actually light, which our eyes can detect the light from the 400 nanometer to 700 or 750, as per your book, it is nanometer. Our eye is sensitive to this, and it gives us a knowledge about the world. When light falls on object, we can see it. Correct? This ray optics is based on the particle theory, that is corpuscle theory of light, which was proposed first by the scientist, that is in the 1637, before Newton was born. Newton was born in 1642, and he gave this theory, he proposed this theory in 1637. The Sir Isaac Newton further developed the corpuscular model of the light. This model, he proposed this, and Isaac Newton, he developed this further, this model, corpuscular theory. And he assumed that the corpuscles, they are the spherical balls, elastic. Correct? And light travels in the form of the corpuscle. He also said that the color of the light is due to the different sizes of the corpuscle or particles. That is, Newton gave the particle theory or corpuscular theory. And he explained rectilinear propagation, laws of reflection and diffraction, formation of images in mirrors and the lenses, and spherical aberrations, the distortion of the image, of optical images, and working and designing of the optical instrument, microscope and telescope, binocular, periscopes, etc. So he could successfully explain this. While explaining the laws of refraction, he made a mistake. There is a failure of the corpuscular theory. It failed to explain the number of optical phenomena discovered later on. The interference, diffraction, polarization, etc. also. They were not discovered at that time. Later on, these phenomena were discovered, and Newton theory could not explain. It could be explained only when the theory of the wave theory, that is given by the Huygens. And while explaining the laws of refraction, he could successfully explain the law of reflection, but refraction he failed. While explaining these laws of refraction, Newton postulated that the speed of corpuscle is more in the water and glass. That is wrong at present. Correct? Another, he said the light travels in the straight line, that is rectilinear propagation. That is also not true. Ordinarily, we do not see the light. Ordinarily, it is seen that light travels in a straight line because shadow is formed. And he also said that light travels with the enormous speed of light, that is a 3 lakh kilometers, that is true. Now, in 1678, the Dutch physicist Christian Huygens, he was born in 1629, when Newton was not born even, put forward the wave theory of light. This model could satisfactorily explain the phenomena of reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, polarization, all. So, at present, there are two theories, wave theory, light travels in the form of waves, and light travels in the form of particle. But particle, that Newton's corpuscular theory or particle theory of light, that could not explain number of phenomena. So, we accept that it travels in the form of waves, that is electromagnetic waves, we already studied in the chapter 8. Now, this theory also could not explain certain phenomena, that is a photoelectric effect, we will see in the, that is a second last, next to next chapter, that is chapter 11, correct? There, that is a light is a photon, is a quanta, is travels in the form of quanta. So, there is a little history about the nature of light. So, scientists, they use which suits to them. Sometimes it behaves as a particle, sometimes it behaves as a wave, but actually it is photons, correct? This is photon is associated with the wave, is a particle like this, having the wave. This is photons. The photon is not neither wave nor particle. It's a particle having the associated with the wave. And this wave has frequency, the energy E is equal to h nu. Nu is the frequency. And that is equal to h c upon lambda. Lambda is the wavelength. Another thing, Newton theory could not explain the colors of a thin film of oil formed on the water surface. He said that the color of the light, that is red, etc., vibgyor, that is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. These colors are due to the different sizes of the corpuscular. Like this, sizes of the corpuscle. That is wrong. It is wrong. The colors are due to the, that depends upon the wavelength. It is due to the different wavelength. We know that the red light has wavelength, that is about 700 nanometer, and violet has 400 nanometer, correct? 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to minus 9. You can write in Aston also, 4000 Aston unit or 7000. It is actually 750. In your book, this data is given, so I have given.
Reflection.
When light falls on a substance, transparent substance, there are three phenomena takes place. It reflects, it transmits, and it absorbs. Part of the light is transmitted also. Suppose if it is a denser medium glass, then it will, this is refracted portion, and part of the light will be transmitted and absorbed, correct? So that absorption makes it hot. Here laws of reflection we will see only, that is incident angle I is equal to reflected angle. You know already yourself, this is incident ray, IR is the incident ray. This is a normal to the surface, perpendicular 90 degree to the surface. And this one is reflected like this. The two angles are the same. You can prove easily this angle plus this angle is equal to 90. This angle plus this angle is also 90. This is right angle. Correct. So I is equal to R. This is called the regular reflection. Correct. Regular reflection. In regular reflection, angle of incidence I is equal to angle of reflection. That is same for all reflecting surfaces, whether it is a lens, mirror, or any other also. We will see later on about the lens and mirror. Now, sign convention. Correct. Before that, there are some terminology you know already. Just I will tell you in a short. Correct. Pole. Pole is the geometrical center of a mirror or a lens. Suppose this is mirror. This is geometrical center. This is a pole. If it is a lens, then it is called optical center. In the case of the lens, this is optical center. This is pole. P is a pole and this is optical. Who is the center? Correct. This is pole. In the case of the mirror, this is mirror and this P is the pole. Then principal focus, if it is F, this is axis, correct. This is the center of curvature, correct. Actually, mirror is a part of the sphere, correct. Suppose this is a sphere and this is a part of a sphere, this is a mirror. The center of the sphere of which the mirror forms a part. See, this is M1, M2 is the mirror, and then this center is the center of curvature of a spherical mirror. That is correct. And line joining the C to the P, the passing one, this is called the principal axis. Correct. This is its axis. That is principal axis. We have already studied. So, I am not writing details, just I will speak it, try to understand. The principal axis is the axis passing from the center of curvature. This is C is the center of curvature, correct? Now see, this is C is the center of curvature. So, any line drawn on this mirror, that will be at 90 degree. So, if ray is going from the C, passing from the C, after the flare, it will retrace its path. So, if it goes like this, it will retrace its path because it is normal. So, itself is a normal. So, if it is normal, then angle is zero. Angle of incidence is zero. So, reflected angle will be also zero. Correct? These laws are followed by mirrors and lenses also. Then, principal focus. F, the rays parallel to the principal axis after reflection or reflection, correct, this is reflected, pass from the point, they converge to the point or appear to diverge from that point in the case of the convex mirror. Suppose mirror is convex. Then rays parallel to the principal axis, they will reflect like this. So, they will diverge, so they will never meet and form the real image. If we produce them back, it seems to appear to come from the point. This point is the, this is a virtual focus in the case of the convex mirror. This is convex. Correct. This is concave. So in the case of concave, it has a real focus. In the case of a convex, it has a virtual focus. So rays after parallel to the principal axis after reflection, in the case of the mirror, or suppose it is lens, then after refraction, they will pass through that and they will meet other side, that is right side of the lens. Really, this is a convex lens, and convex lens has a real focus, you know. Or if it is a concave lens, then they appear to diverge from that point. If it is a concave lens, this is a principal axis, correct? Rays parallel to the principal axis, they will refract in the case of lenses. So they will go. This is a diverging lens also, it is called, because ray after passing through the lens, they diverge, they do not converge as in the case of the convex. So they will not meet really, but if we produce them back, they appear to come from the point. This is the principal focus, but virtual focus appear to diverge from this point, correct? In the case of the convex, as I told you, it has a real focus. See, this is principal axis. They will meet. This is a real focus. Then aperture, correct? Aperture, this is the circular periphery is called the aperture. Or you can see this is a mirror, concave mirror, this one is the aperture. This is a linear aperture, correct? Or if you want to see this angular aperture, that is angle subtended here at the center of curvature. See, this is a mirror. So these are some terms. Then focal length is the distance from the pole to the, we will see, to the principal focus. This is the principal focus. Distance from the pole, this is a pole, to the principal focus is called the focal length. Distance from the pole to the center of curvature is the radius of curvature. Now some sign convention. The object is on the left. Object is always placed on the left side. This is the mirror, concave mirror. The object is placed on the left side. Image may be right side or left side. If in the case of the concave mirror, if images are real, they will be formed on the left side. Distance is measured in the direction of incident light ray direction. This is an object, so ray will go from the object toward the left to the right. So left to right distances which are measured, they will be taken as a positive, correct? So this is incident light ray direction, and they are taken as a positive distance. That is, left to right is measured as a positive distance. Whereas right to left, that is from pole to the left side, that is negative. All distance, remember, all distance measured from the pole as a origin. So distance is not measured like this, it is from this. Correct? This is direction of F. So this direction is opposite direction than that of the incident ray light direction. So this is negative. In the case of concave mirror, where there is a, it is negative. Correct? Or maybe lens. Correct? So concave, you remember, concave focal length is always negative. Whether it is lens or mirror. Convex, it is always positive. Lens or mirror, you can remember this way. Correct? Object distance is always negative. V may be negative or positive measure. So now image of this is formed here, because this is between the C and F. So image will be between the this is object is beyond C, so image will be between C and F, and that is real inverted, correct, and smaller in size. This distance is more, this distance is less. We will see later on. You have already studied, you know. So image is inverted and down the principal axis. So this distance is, this height is measured negatively. Above this, upward to the principal axis, this is the principal axis, correct. The distance measured upward the principal axis are taken as a positive, correct. Now focal plane, here one definition is left. So if rays are parallel but not making some angle with the principal axis, this CFP is a principal axis and it makes some angle, so they will follow the laws of reflection. So this ray A will be reflected as a, this angle is equal to the this reflected angle, this is A dash, this is reflected ray, it reflect like this, correct. This is B ray, it's in this also the incident angle is equal to reflected angle, and B is reflected like this, correct. These two rays intersect here, so this is the image of the top of the object. Object I have not shown, it is far away, correct. So for formation of image, there are number of rays coming from the object. Suppose this object, there are number of rays, but we take only two rays for formation of image. Otherwise, it will become a complicated to study the image. Now, focal length and relation between the focal length and the radius of curvature also, correct. So focal length is PF, this is the focal length F, and PC, this distance is the radius of curvature, that is R. Consider the angle, this ray is going parallel, it will, as we have seen that in the definition of the principal focus, how will it reflect? Parallel ray after reflection will pass from the F, or appear to come from that in the case of the convex mirror. This is a concave mirror, so really it will pass, this is a real ray, correct. So now this is a line drawn from the center of curvature, that is always normal, correct. So this, it follows the laws of reflection, so incident angle is equal to reflected angle. So you can see I is equal to IR all theta, and this also theta, correct. So these two lines are parallel, so this angle is equal to, then this cut intersect, so this angle is equal to this angle. This exterior angle is equal to sum of the interior two angle of a triangle, correct. That is, this, consider this triangle, correct, MCF. That is, this is exterior angle, MFD is the exterior angle. So that is 2 theta, the sum of the two interior angle. So 10 MCP, this is angle is theta, MCP is theta. And MFP is, this will be equal to 2 theta. Now 10 theta is equal to MD upon CD. 10 theta is equal to, this is, take 10 theta is equal to MD upon CD, and 10 2 theta is equal to MD upon FD, MD upon FD. Now for a small angle, these are paraxial rays, rays parallel to the principal axis and near to the axis, correct. I have shown for convenience little far, like it seems to be marginal, but they are not marginal, they are paraxial, very close to this. To make it clear, to make the figure clear, I have shown some distance. So they are very close, correct. So angle is very small. So for a small angle, 10 theta can be taken as a theta. So theta is equal to MD upon CD, MD upon CD. And 2 theta is equal to MD upon FD also. So MD upon FD is equal to 2MD upon CD, 2MD upon, because this is theta, this is 2 theta, correct. So just put it, instead of theta 2, 2 theta is equal to MD upon 2MD, 2 theta will be 2 multiplied by 2, 2 CD upon, correct. So MD upon FD is equal to, this is 2MD upon CD. So FD is equal to CD upon 2. The point D is very close to the point P. Now point D is very close to the point P. So FD can be taken as FP or PF. Correct? Better to take the PF because this is measured from the pole. But it doesn't make any difference if you make, but you have to write the proper sign. So FD is equal to PF, and PF is the focal length. PF is the, this distance is the focal length. And this distance is the radius of curvature. Correct? So FD is equal to PF, and that is equal to focal length F, and CD is equal to similarly CP, and that is radius of curvature R. So F is equal to, FD is F and CD is R, CD is CP, that is F is R by 2, that is focal length is half of the radius of curvature. Same thing you can prove in the case of the convex mirror also. Ray is coming like this. Now it will follow the laws of reflection. So incident angle is equal to reflected angle. This is incident angle, this is reflected angle. Don't make a mistake, don't draw like this, correct? So this is the normal. The line passing from the C is called the 90 degree, as we have seen in the definition. Because any line drawn, because mirror is a part of the sphere. Mirror is a part of a sphere. And in definition also we have seen the center of curvature of the mirror is the center of the sphere of which mirror is a part. So this is part. So any line drawn, this will be a 90 degree. Correct? So this is normal, 90 degree line is a C, line drawn from the C to the mirror. This is 90 degree. So it is normal, correct? This. So this angle will be equal to this angle, vertically opposite angle, this two crosses. This is theta, correct? So this will be 2 theta. So same way you can prove it, that is same symbols. We have not changed the symbol, correct? And I leave it to you to check it.